In 2020, Brisbane Airport opened a new parallel runway, which introduced new flight paths designed to suit the orientation of both runways, the locations they would service, the types of planes that would use them, and the typical wind conditions. This major airport infrastructure development shaped how Brisbane's airspace works today. Airservices Australia plays a vital role in managing Brisbane's busy skies. Our top priority is safety, while also balancing efficient operations, reducing environmental impact, and minimising aircraft noise. Air traffic controllers manage planes flying in Brisbane's controlled airspace and on the ground at the airport, including during taxiing, takeoff, and landing. Outside controlled airspace, smaller general aviation aircraft, like pilot training planes and police helicopters, operate without instruction from air traffic controllers. These aircraft must follow safety rules set by CASA and are responsible for safely navigating around the airspace using information provided by air services. General aviation plays an important role in Brisbane skies, providing services like pilot training, medical transport, aerial surveying and assessment, as well as recreational flying. The flight paths at Brisbane Airport have been designed to manage the flow of planes based on where they're coming from or where they're going to. Flights from or going to the north or west use the new or western runway flight paths. Flights from or going to the south or east use the legacy or eastern runway flight paths. Brisbane's airspace includes restricted zones for military training, which only military aircraft can access. Brisbane's flight paths are designed to avoid these restricted areas to maintain safe separation between civilian and military operations. For planes arriving into Brisbane Airport, there are two main approach procedures used to guide planes safely onto the runways. The instrument landing system is a long, straight path lined up with the runway that is particularly valuable in bad weather or during low visibility. It helps pilots to line up with the runway and descend at a consistent, gradual angle to land. This is the main approach used at Brisbane Airport, and there is one for each runway end. The second approach is the required navigation performance, authorisation required approach, which uses GPS navigation following a shorter, curved path to the runway. Only planes with special GPS equipment and certified crew can use this approach. When required, air traffic controllers may adjust operations to suit conditions, including manually directing individual planes to avoid areas of poor weather or to ensure safe separation between aircraft. For aircraft departing Brisbane Airport, there are two types of departures available. A standard instrument departure follows published flight paths like a road in the sky, automatically keeping planes safely separated. A radar departure lets controllers direct planes individually, using compass headings to turn them early or send them in a particular direction. This is especially useful when weather is poor, when a slower plane is taking off prior to a faster plane and it needs to be moved out of its path, and when a heavily laden plane is not able to meet the requirements on one of the standard departure paths. At times, planes that have departed on a standard instrument departure path will be taken off this path and issued an instruction to track direct to another point to maintain separation from other aircraft or to avoid bad weather. Air traffic controllers follow noise abatement procedures to help reduce noise impacts on local communities. These include specific operating modes, preferred flight paths, and nighttime restrictions. However, their use depends on weather, safety, operational requirements, and pilot assessment of their operational needs at any given time, which sometimes limits the use of these procedures. Most of the time, Brisbane Airport operates in standard parallel runway mode. This involves aircraft either arriving over Moreton Bay and departing over the city, or arriving over the city and departing over Moreton Bay. Did you know that planes take off and land into the wind because it's safer? Brisbane's subtropical climate and seasonal changes affect wind direction and impact which runway and which flight paths are used. When Brisbane's southeasterly winds are blowing, planes approach the runway over Moreton Bay and take off over Brisbane. When the winds shift to westerly or northerly, planes approach overland and depart over Moreton Bay. As the wind changes, so do the flight paths used, affecting different areas. If the wind stays the same for a long time, the same runway and flight paths are used, meaning some areas experience noise for longer periods. We understand that community would like all aircraft to land and take off over the bay, but it is not that simple. This can occur in a mode called SOD props, simultaneous opposite direction parallel runway operations. In this mode, planes take off and land over the waters of Moreton Bay, which reduces noise over Brisbane suburbs. However, SOD props can only be used when the skies aren't too busy and weather conditions are just right, making it a low capacity mode. During peak times and busy daytime hours, when more flights are scheduled, it is not possible to use this mode. Improvements to flight paths and air traffic control procedures have been implemented to increase our ability to use this mode, but as the airspace gets busier, its use will diminish over time. At times, like during poor weather, runway works, or limited staff availability, air traffic controllers may use what's called a segregated operating mode. In this mode, planes land on one runway and take off from the other. It helps manage flights safely and keeps operations moving when the airport isn't able to operate as normal. There are four of these segregated modes. Each mode is a different way of managing flights during these times, depending on wind direction and which runway is best suited for arrivals or departures. Until now, most of these operations have used the western runway for flights over land. But in 2024, additional modes were added so they can be shared more fairly between both runways. The Brisbane airspace system is large and complex with many factors to consider. At Airservices Australia, we are dedicated to providing safe, efficient, and environmentally responsible services to the aviation industry and the community.